Good day, boxing fans. Saturday night in Perth, Australia, two former lightweight champions of the world, Vasyl Lomachenko and the local man George Kambosos Jr., will be trying to regain at least a slice of lost glory when they clash for Kambosos' IBO lightweight title with a vacant, more recognized IBF lightweight championship of the world at stake. If it's a fight that you're interested in breaking down, then stick around and let's do it. Okay, boxing fans. In Australia and the land down under, it's a sort of a do or die situation for both Lomachenko and Kambosos if they want to regain lost glory and remain relevant forces in the lightweight division. Both have lost to Devin Haney in the case of Kambosos twice, and in the case of Lomachenko, maybe with some controversy, there are those who felt he did enough to beat Devin Haney for the undisputed title. To be honest, I scored Lomachenko a two-point winner over Devin Haney, but there were many close rounds, especially in the first two-thirds of a fight, that could have gone this way or that way, so I won't cry robbery. I thought Lomachenko edged it, but I can't complain too much with Haney getting the decision. There are things that I think Lomachenko should have done. Now, Kambosos Jr., he had that very stirring upset win. I think it was probably the upset of, 2021, And I watched it early morning here, our side, and it was very exciting. We upset Teofimo Lopez to become unified world lightweight champion. Now, that was up and over, and Kambosos, Lopez on the floor, Lopez had Kambosos on the floor, and he pulled off this massive upset and fought outside himself that night. And it was one of the things that makes boxing great, that kind of upset. But he had his moment in the sun, and then he had to face Devin Haney. And Haney basically just shut him down and completely outboxed him. There was one of those rematches in the contract, and it had to be done again. Haney basically did the same thing with Kambosos. That's one thing that I don't like with rematches in the contracts, you know. A rematch for me should be when a fight was close, maybe there was some sort of controversy. It was a very exciting, competitive fight. If one fighter wins, clearly, I don't really want to see a rematch, but I understand it was in the contract there. But Haney against Kambosos 2 was a bit pointless to me. Guys, tell me in the comment section if you agree what of my feeling there about rematches like these. But that's besides the point now. It's a new page, and Lomachenko also now has to get back in the win column. It's a chance for him to become lightweight champion, albeit only one of the sanctioning body belts, two if you count the IBO. Don't know if you do. But it's a chance for him to win another world title. He's already a three division world champion. Now, can he do it? Now, on paper, if we look at George Kambosos, he's had a sort of a gutsy, hard scrabble way to the top, and it didn't last long, as we saw. Now, you know, he got his title shot with a pair of split decision wins over Mickey Bay and Lee Selby. So he didn't just crash through the door. He had to really work hard and grind his way through to that place where he got to post the upset over Teofimo Lopez. And then Devin Haney, I think, showed us that George Kambosos may be world-class, but he's not an elite fighter. He had his Buster Douglas moments, but it didn't look good against Devin Haney. And then in his last fight, he faced a southpaw, like Lomachenko, and Maxi Hughes. And to me, he won a majority decision, but many people thought Maxi Hughes deserved to win that fight. To me, in the Maxi Hughes fight, he was outboxed, you know. And in America, if a guy boxes on the back foot, the judges are usually not too kind of you. And I think that is what happened there to Maxi Hughes. I thought Hughes did enough to win that fight. Whatever, Kambosos looked very bad in that fight to me, you know. Hughes timed him with a southpaw straight left. He did basic southpaw tactics, moving away from the power hand of Kambosos. And Kambosos really struggled, and he sort of looked out at sea there for much of a fight to me. And if you look at Lomachenko, of course, his amateur career, 396-1, who's got that? And he's vastly more experience against the top guys than Kambosos is. Now, Kambosos has been against the best, but I don't think he's fought as many guys at the very top as Lomachenko did. So I think Lomachenko, on paper, if we look at this, then Lomachenko shouldn't have too much trouble with George Kambosos. Kambosos is the taller guy with a reach advantage, but so are almost everybody at lightweight against Lomachenko. So why is this an interesting fight to me? Guys, if it's an interesting fight to you, please remember, smash that like button. I'll greatly appreciate it. It helps the YouTube channel. But a reason why I think this is interesting is because Lomachenko is 36. Nowadays in boxing, it's not that old anymore. But he's had some hard fights. And I think lightweight is not the best division for Lomachenko. He's a bit undersized. He'll be better down at junior lightweight. And he's getting on a little bit. And I've seen certain things in Lomachenko. In the Teofimo Lopez fight, he's only lost three times. The first was his second fight when he tried to win a world title. In only two fights, he succeeded in his third pro fight where he got sort of out-hustled by Orlando Salido. That we can chuck in the dustbin. That was long ago. And then the two losses against Teofimo Lopez and Devin Haney. Now, in the Lopez loss, he had a shoulder injury that it was revealed later. And notwithstanding, Lopez boxed very well that night, and Lomachenko, to me, just took too long to get going, gave away too many of the earlier rounds, and then came on late in the fight, and it was too late. Against Devin Haney, I also think he got off to a little bit of a slow start, and then a lot of those rounds were close rounds. You know, Lomachenko in the first half, and Haney does something in the second half, or vice versa. So Lomachenko, to me, seems to be pacing himself a lot more than he once did. And could it be close to the end or the end for Lomachenko now? Because not getting the decision against Devin Haney is also something that I think psychologically gave him quite a knock. And we know the situation of the war in Ukraine. On top of that, you know, those are heavy burdens to carry. So that to me gives George Kambosos a real shot in this fight, as well as the fact that it's on home turf. Now, it's in Australia. We know, if you think back, Manny Pacquiao against Jeff Horn and quite a few other fights. It's not easy to win on the road in Australia. You can't say it's Australia. It's not easy to win on the road for a visiting fighter anywhere. The only place, I think, in the world where you can feel calm as a visiting fighter, you're going to get a fair shake, is Japan. So the rest of it, if you're a visiting fighter, you're up against it, and that includes my native South Africa, I'll admit that too. So if Kambosos can simply keep busy, be the aggressor, and put enough hands on Lomachenko to make the rounds close, I'm sure he's going to get the decision with the judges. But Lomachenko surely knows that. He must know it by now. He must know it. The judges are not going to do him any favors. They didn't against Lopez. They didn't against Devin Haney. They didn't against Orlando Salido. So he's got to have an understanding in his mind now that he's not the A-side fighter necessarily. Perhaps he never really was. And he has to fight accordingly. So I think Lomachenko, if he's not growing old, and if he can fight for at least 2 minutes of every 3 minutes of every round from round 1 to round 12, because look how Haney beat Kambosos in Australia. He completely outboxed him and took him out of a fight. And Lomachenko must know that he's going to have to do the same. Now, what can George Kambosos do to win this fight? Guys, tell me in the comment section, what do you think each man must do? And please remember to share this content among your boxing fan friends and family. It helps to get it out there. But I think what George Kambosos must do here, I don't think he can wait back and try and box with Lomachenko. You know, that wouldn't be the right tactics. Lomachenko is a master boxer. He's going to have to learn lessons from the near loss that he had there against Maxi Hughes. And he's going to have to be much better, because if he fights the way he fought against Maxi Hughes, Lomachenko is just going to win every round. I've got no doubt about that. But he's intelligent enough to know that. So Kambosos this time, he's going to have to work on his mistakes. He's going to have to watch that southpaw straight left coming at him. He's going to have to keep his hands busy, and he's going to have to come forward in a calculated way against Vasyl Lomachenko. And if we look at what worked for Devin Haney against Lomachenko, What worked very well for Haney was the right hand. The classic reply to a southpaw, but not just a straight right hand. It was more sort of a right hand straight shot to the body, or sort of a sweeping uppercut to the body. And he hit Ramachenko that time and time again and prevented him from quite getting into a rhythm and spots. So Kambosos should take a leaf out of the Haney book, and he should bang that body with the right of Lomachenko. It's going to be much easier to hit the body, because Lomachenko keeps his hands high like that. And he also has this brilliant footwork at the angles. He's almost like a tap dancer in front of you. So Haney Kambosos is going to have to work the body of Lomachenko. He's going to have to be the aggressor. He's going to have to stay busy. He's going to have to use his height and reach. He shouldn't try and box like Haney did. He's not good enough a boxer. He must turn this into a sort of ugly fight and just keep throwing punches and work that body of Lomachenko. I think the body is a key for George Kambosos if he wants to pull it off here. As for Lomachenko, he's got to be Lomachenko, you know. He's just got to do what he does, but he's got to do it more consistently when he's done in some fights in the past. He can't throw away the first four rounds, and he can't keep the rounds close that you have to have a debate after every round. Lomachenko landed the clearest shots, but Kambosos outpointed him by two, or Lomachenko landed a combination, and then Kambosos landed a huge right hand that made him take a step back. There mustn't be that debate after every round. It's much easier said than done, because at this level that's not easy. But that's what Lomachenko is going to have to do. He's going to have to put a pasting on George Kambosos, and he'll have to outclass him in every way, like Devin Haney did. Now the question is, can he do it? Guys, tell me in the comment section, who do you have and why do you have him? Do you think George Kambosos Jr. pulls it off in front of his home crowd? Do you think Lomachenko walks into the lion's den and shows us once again why he's high-tech and one of the best southpaw boxers, one of the best boxers of the last 10 years in the ring, pound for pounders? Haney or Lomachenko, or why? Now, I've got to make a pick here. And for me, it is in Kambosos' hometown. It is older Lomachenko. But I just think the golf and skills to me is a bit too big. You know, Teofimo Lopez made a mistake there against Kambosos in retrospect, not taking anything away from Kambosos. But he underestimated Kambosos, and he brawled with him, and he got into a sort of a barroom, hot, rocky type of thing with fired up Kambosos, who was fighting besides himself. And that was a dumb move on Teofimo Lopez's side. And it's a win that aged very well for Kambosos, because look what Lopez did against Josh Taylor. But that notwithstanding, I think Kambosos is a guy who fights up to the level of his opposition. It just depends. It worked against Teofimo Lopez. It couldn't work against Devin Haney. And Haney, I know, is different. Ramachenko is a different fighter than Haney. But I think it's still a southpaw. Southpaw is a style that clearly is not something that Kambosos is good at facing. And he's a much better southpaw than Max Hughes. Kambosos will be a lot better than he was against Hughes, I'm sure. But I don't think it's going to be enough. I think in the end of the day, Lomachenko is going to be a clear winner. And that'll give him a close win on the cards. So I am going with Lomachenko by a very close, but a close sort of split decision to pull it out in this fight. And I think he will do it quite clearly, but I think the cards will be narrower than the fight itself really is. So I'm going for Lomachenko here. Tell me what you think, and let's see if Lomachenko can regain the magic, or if George Kambosos can pull off another stirring win. So until I see you guys again, please remember to subscribe, and also remember to keep those hands up.